Hey everybody, and welcome to Pick My Solar Live. This is our 50th anniversary of Pick My Solar Live. I am Andrew Baer, introduced by a new friend, JD Sorrentino.
JD, I'm an energy advisor over here at Pick My Solar.
Yeah. So let's get right into the topic this week. We're talking about are the best inverters or the inverters that sold the most in 2018. So, as always, ask us anything and leave a comment in the chat box, and we will get to that as soon as you ask it, really. Or we'll get to it next week if it comes late. So, our top inverter in 2019 was SolarEdge with 63%.
Yeah, not surprising, really. A lot of installers are utilizing SolarEdge from what I can tell these days.
Yeah. Why is that, do you think?
I think it's lower cost equipment versus microinverters. Also, their warranty with SolarEdge, they include both parts and labor if there's a replacement. So it's really seamless for them and, you know, not any worry after the installation.
Yeah, and so what you can see here is SolarEdge took 63%, and then SunPower and Enphase, when combined, were a little under 40. So it's like a 60-40 split between SolarEdge and the rest. And the rest, the SunPower and Enphase, are microinverters. So that's kind of the split we're seeing between string plus optimizers and microinverters. And we'll explain that to you guys just in a second here. But so really, given that, it seems like that there's not really a bad option. It's a little bit of personal preference. It's almost 50-50. So getting into SolarEdge, you gave us a little bit of breakdown, but what are people liking about SolarEdge?
Yeah, so one of my favorite things about SolarEdge is the monitoring system. It gives you panel-level monitoring. A lot of people like that. It just gives you a deep dive into your system. As I said before, there's less parts for the installer, so it's typically less expensive to install. And also, you're getting a manufacturer warranty that covers both parts and labor. I always recommend to my customers to getting extended 25-year warranty. The standard is 12, so then you're covered in out-of-pocket costs if there's an issue with the inverter for that full 25 years.
Yeah, and so what's going on with the SolarEdge is they have a string plus optimizers, which gives you some of the benefits of a microinverter, which means that if one panel goes down, your whole system isn't going to go down. You'll still get the production from the rest of the panels, which is a new feature to string inverters to make them more competitive.
Yeah, definitely.
And then our next one is SunPower, and you can see on the back of the panel in the picture there, that's where their microinverter is located, and that's about how big it is. But the SunPower inverters come with the SunPower module.
Right.
And so these typically, I'm thinking, go to customers looking for a premium product.
Yeah, so, you know, SunPower, most efficient panels on the market. And they actually they acquired a microinverter company a few years back called SolarBridge in Austin, Texas, to bring that portion in house. So now everything's factory integrated. You have that microinverter preloaded, quicker install. Everything just snaps in together. So SunPower installers really like that product. They have a great monitoring system as well. And you know, getting a full 25-year warranty, SunPower does back their installations, parts and labor, for 25 years as well. So if that's something folks are interested in, you're still getting that full bumper-to-bumper warranty.
Never missing an opportunity to talk about Texas over here.
Yeah,
this guy. Yeah, I've seen SunPower's monitoring system, and it's one of the slickest that I've come across. And I've looked at Enphase, SolarEdge, and SunPower. And they're all pretty good, to be fair, but SunPower just, like, does everything a little bit better, it seems. And then the last one, which had, I think it was 13% of our sales this year, was Enphase. So this is a pretty standard microinverter that you can apply to a lot of panels. And what are customers saying about this one?
Well, you know, Enphase has been around for quite a while. And, you know, once again, I'm going to hit on the warranties, 25-year warranty with Enphase. And since Enphase was kind of one of the first microinverters to come around, if a customer knows they want microinverters, that's the one that you're going to. And, you know, reliable product, and they have some really cool things coming down the road as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And just to touch on microinverters, since we didn't do that, is a microinverter at each individual panel will convert your AC, your DC electricity from the panel into AC energy. And so that means that you will get the maximum power possible from your entire system all the time. And so that's great, obviously, but it comes with a little bit of a price premium, which is why it's not needed on every project.
Right. Yeah, you're gonna see a little bit more materials involved in microinverters. One point I forgot to make for both microinverter systems, they're typically less parts. You know, with central inverters, people don't like seeing, some folks don't like seeing a large box on the side of their wall. With microinverters, since all the equipment is on the roof, it's much less lower, or it's much lower profile. Aesthetics or something that's important to folks.
For sure. So in general, the microinverter stuff goes to people looking for more than just production. They want like a better look, the most power possible, stuff like that.
Yeah.
That's what it seems like. And the last one that we're going to talk about is SMA. And they actually didn't have any sales from us in 2019, but they're a product that used to get a decent amount, so just wanted to bring them up. And these guys are a regular string inverter.
Yeah, I think you probably see SMA a lot more these days with large commercial projects. Yeah. On the residential end, you used to see a lot of SMA. One cool thing that SMA has is a secure power supply. So there's a small outlet that gets installed with the SMA inverter. I think it gives you about 1,200 watts that you can use if the event your system goes down and the sun is shining, you're actually able to use a little bit of power from your system rather than the system shutting down. So just a cool little factoid about them.
That is a really nice feature.
Yeah.
But the reason that they're not selling, I'm assuming, is because they're just regular string inverters.
Right, yeah, and what really scares people about normal string inverters is if one panel has an issue, it affects the system as a whole. And that's why we're seeing the SolarEdge with the DC optimization, the hybrid inverter, as well as micros with Enphase and SunPower, because if one panel has an issue, it doesn't affect the system as a whole.
Yeah, absolutely. I could see that being a big concern. Yeah. Yeah, and so this is comparing our 2017 versus our 2018 sales. And so you can see that SolarEdge was the leader in both, fell a little bit in 2018, and really the rise of that is due to SunPower. SunPower started selling a lot. I'm thinking part of that is because we started selling a lot more in New York,
right?
And people in New York are going for SunPowers more than other products from what we've seen. Yeah, and Enphase has lost a little bit too, actually. Yeah, I was reading that wrong at first. Enphase and SolarEdge gave way a little bit to SunPower. Yeah, and then I believe that's everything. Just double check. Yeah, so that's our inverters from 2018. Come to Pick My Solar if you want to get free estimates or free bids. And you'll be able to see these inverters along with some sweet panels that installers in your area are offering, and we'll help you choose the best bid for you. That's all I got. All right. Anything to add, JD?
No, I think you nailed it, Bear.
All right. See you guys next week.